I'm Rob Edwards, and I'm an associate professor in computer science at San Diego State University. We're a bioinformatics lab, and so we work closely with people in the biology department. They generate a lot of data. We take that data and we use high-performance computing, and we analyze the data to try and solve some of the problems that they're coming up with. As part of a nationwide project, the National Institutes of Health have been collecting samples from different people to really understand what bacteria are and what our microbiome is. That's all of the bacteria that we have on and in our bodies. As part of our study, we identified a new virus that's about 10 times larger than HIV, and it's in about 50 to 75% of the population. It's a virus that specifically attacks bacteria. So we call those bacteriophage, or just phage for short. So this virus is targeting a bacteria called Bacteroides. And these bacteria are really interesting because they've been implicated in a lot of health issues. Things like obesity and diabetes are really being dramatically affected by the bacteria in our intestines in ways that we aren't yet sure about. We're still trying to uncover what they're doing. We named it crAssphage because we developed a computational tool called CRAS for cross-assembly analysis. We identified that this phage is in different samples at different concentrations in each sample. So we put all of those DNA sequences together in one bucket and analyzed those as a group, and that's when this genome really came popping out at us. Once we had identified the virus computationally, we actually teamed up with the biology department and worked to identify the virus in fecal samples and also to test our ideas, our hypotheses, that this is a single virus, a single genome that we can amplify.
My name is John Montilli. My area of research and indeed my area of expertise is in virus discovery. My role was to try to confirm that what they found bioinformatically was actually in the sample. We were able to amplify the DNA from the original sample, and then we were able to confirm that what they found by computer method was actually the virus that was present in the actual sample. So the match was quite remarkable, almost 100% similarity.
As far as we can tell, it's as old as humans are. It's very widespread. It's in every continent that we've looked at. And we know that the bacteria that the virus is associated with have been with us for a very long time. We've no idea how it's transmitted. Presumably, we acquire it from our mothers or maybe our friends or other people around us.
At this stage, we don't know if there is any health implication about finding this crAssphage. One thing we know that this virus is very abundant. Every other person has the virus in his body.
And so we're really curious about what this phage is doing to the Bacteroides. So that's something that we're going to focus on in our future studies, to try and understand really how this phage is interacting with Bacteroides and what those interactions mean for us, depending on how much of the phage and the bacteria we have.
Discovering a virus is very important, particularly for viruses that are harmful. And then you start thinking about, hey, how can you generate the antibody against different parts of this virus? And you can even start thinking about how can you design a vaccine to protect individuals against that particular virus.
In the future, we're heading to personalized phage medicine. And the idea there is that we can take your phage, we can isolate your phage, and we can manipulate that, and then we could give that back to you. And this could be a really novel way to develop therapeutics for things like diabetes, for other intestinal diseases like Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, that are really debilitating and important diseases that we know are caused by bacteria and we need to figure out solutions for.